In front of each one of you here, you should find you have a picture, which is a picture of a genuine United States Patent Office patent application. Arthur, have a look at yours, shall we? And Clive, yours looks like this. And Vic. And Alan, you've got a picture too.
Well, it's some sort of electrified Christmas stocking. It's a shoe bomb. Why would you want an electrified Christmas stocking anyway?
It's a Santa Claus detector.
Oh, of course.
It's got a motion detection. You hang it amongst your other stockings, and when Santa Claus comes, it triggers a light and an alarm.
There's no such thing as
I
Santa.
I know there isn't.
Waste of time.
Waste of time. Clive, this looks like a bra where you've got a little nozzle and you can blow down it to inflate the bra. So this is clearly designed for a woman who maybe thinks
a
one of her...
A woman with no arms.
Oh, yes. I wasn't going to mention that. She's got one breast she feels is slightly smaller than the other, but she doesn't make a big thing of it, except when she's walking past somebody who she fancies, so she can quickly and surreptitiously and inflate the breast.
It's odd enough, your breath was going in the wrong direction. You were blowing when you should be sucking.
So you suck...
You basically have drink in your bra. Yeah. And you can surreptitiously suck your drink out of it.
It's only going to be for red wine, though, isn't it? Because it's going to be too warm for white wine or beer or...
Oh, what about Ovaltine?
Oh!
Can I have one of those Ovaltine bras? I've heard so much about. She came in here reeking of Ovaltine.
What's yours, young Arthur?
Ah, yes. I remember Clive Anderson in his thyrsus. I can't hardly believe it, but maybe someone has actually patented the comb over.
Yeah, absolutely right. On May the 10th, 1977, Frank Smith from Orlando, Florida, filed a patent for a method of styling hair to cover partial baldness using only the hair on a person's head.
But why is his head the colour of a baboon's arms?
Have you got the full details of this that I could take away and study?
If you look at this picture, though, what you'll see is a horse with its tail. And that's just the end of it.
Yes. Vic, what have you got for us?
This is a device for sucking those special gases out of a U-bend. And it looks like an actual pan that's filled with some sort of worms. Which probably create the gas in the U-bend.
Well, you're more or less right. It is a device for allowing you to breathe in the event of a fire in a hotel room. You pop it. It's called the toilet snorkel.
So, your last moments before the fire burns your backside off, you spent sucking in
basically
lavatory air.
Lavatory air. Darling, I just want to find, where's the toilet snorkel? Yeah.